Hello, Salem. I'm your mayor, Chuck Bennett, and here with another monthly edition of all the great things happening at the City of Salem. If you haven't heard, I'll be delivering this year's State of the City address on February 9th at the Salem Convention Center at noon. The Salem Rotary Club is hosting the event. It runs from 11:30 to 1. Come join us for lunch. It'll stream in real time or catch us later on CC Media Cable Channel 21 throughout the month. Find all the options on the City of Salem website. Also, along with our social service partners, we're wrapping up the annual point-in-time count in our community. This count of individuals who are experiencing homelessness is required by the federal government. The data gathered helps distribute vital resources to reduce hardships that lead to homelessness. It also helps to provide services to those living unsheltered in our community and increase access to affordable housing for our residents and families, those with children who are unsheltered or at risk of becoming homeless. And if you haven't already heard, City Manager Steve Powers is officially retiring. On February 24th from 4:30 to 6, we'll be honoring his service with a virtual retirement party. Please join us, and we really want to thank him for his hard work and accomplishments during his 6 years of service to Salem. Today, I'm pleased to have as my guest interview Dan Clem, Executive Director of the Union Gospel Mission. He's going to talk about the new facility and how they continue to serve homeless individuals in our community. Well, Dan, great to see you. Dan Clem, the executive director of Union Gospel Mission, is here with me today. Dan and I served on the city council together, so we're kind of used to talking to each other in this room.
That's right.
So it's really a pleasure to have you here. I got a batch of things I'd love to talk to you about. I wish we had an hour. We've got about 10, 15 minutes.
Okay.
So I'm going to run through some issues that I think might give you a chance to help people understand what's going on, particularly at the new mission.
Sure.
The new mission. Tell us a little about that.
It's three-story, 57,000 square feet. It's designed in a way that provides dignity and respect. It's off of commercial. It's not on a state highway. Previously, the men were having to mill around out in public view. That wasn't dignity and respect for them, and it certainly wasn't healthy for the community. As well, it's right across the street from the police department. So, Chuck, I don't even know that we could have planned something.
I don't think
something.
We even planned it that way.
Well, it proved that God's at work. But I think we also constructed in a manner that keeps it out of the eyes of the police department. So the guys, you know, even if they've had some past run-ins with law enforcement, can come in and seek the help that they need to have.
Men only. You say guys.
Men only, but no. Women are more than invited to come in, get showers, laundry, meals. Just due to the nature of some of the lives that the guys have led, sleeping there is not possible. But I will tell you, we are very, very excited about some future projects to do much better work for and meet the needs for the ladies, particularly
looking at
a
women's center.
Well, I can't announce anything at this time, but just know, go to bed tonight trusting that we are anxiously and prayerfully have plans on the drawing board.
How long has the Union Gospel Mission served this community and this group of people?
Yeah, five Christian businessmen came together in 1953 and said, you know, we want to help.
Wow.
We've got six soup kitchens throughout downtown. You know, let's bring it all together. Let's support it in a meaningful way that it isn't just hand to mouth, but more than a meal, a safe place to sleep, a safe place to get three hot meals a day most of the time. And really just provide a way for them to get out of their addictions or out of their lifestyle. And it really started with George Samaka, who was stuck in a rail cart for 3 days, had an excerpt from the Bible, and came out of that boxcar just on fire.
That's great.
We enjoy a tremendous heritage of caring for the men, but really about life change as well.
That's great. How do you describe, and you'll hear it, I'm sure, in the community too, where you're engaging people, not enabling people. You know what I mean.
Yeah. Relationships are everything, Chuck.
Yeah.
Coming in, we designed the new facility and as well at Samanka Place in Kaiser for the ladies to engage with them right away. It isn't fill his clipboard out and come back in 2 hours. It's you go right into a counselor's room, you start to build rapport, and it's about building trust. Folks out in the homeless situation, they've led a life where trust isn't a part of it, and neither are really good next decisions. So we don't want to enable them to stay on the street. We don't want them to enable them to not trust. We don't want to enable them to not have relationships. We're just not giving them stuff, Chuck. We're giving them friendship. We're giving them programs that help them deal with their addictions. And some guys just need a couple months or a couple years, just time out to rebuild, to be restored.
So, right. Does that make UGM a high barrier shelter?
Yeah, we are not.
It's an odd way to say it.
Yeah, UGM is a zero barrier shelter, okay. And there's two caveats to that. You can stay and take advantage of all the services without having to go to chapel. You don't have to ascribe to any belief.
So you got to pray to get a meal.
You don't have to do that anymore. Okay. And because we want to serve everybody. And that's really where our faith is that everybody counts. Every person matters. And so we're zero barrier in that the only rule is if you're a danger to yourself or to others. I mean, you flip a knife out or you say hurtful things, we have to at least ask you to leave that day.
Yeah.
The other issue is that we normal life patterns are not part of their lives. And so when they come in, we ask them to live during the day and get help during the day and sleep at night. Yeah. This idea that we see out in the community where people are essentially sleeping during the day and running around at night, that's not healthy. And so those are our two qualifiers. Other than that, every man, woman, and child that comes into our facilities is served with what they need, maybe not sometimes necessarily what they want.
That's part of the enabling issue too, I think. You all are part of a network of organizations in this community, public and private.
Yeah.
How's that working out? You're probably the biggest organization in town dealing directly with services for the homeless. How is that working right now?
Yeah, we're just so blessed to, by the way, thank you to all of our partners and all the folks who've supported us. We want to be community connected. That's one of our values. And so we are partnering with Church in the Park when they've got somebody who's ready to move out of the camp or the wherever they're at, or even the micro shelters. We've built bridges between their counselors and our counselors so they can come into more permanent shelter and get more permanent life-changing help, address some of the issues that they have, reconnect with their communities, pay off their court fines, do all those necessary things in conjunction with Church in the Park, with Arches, and as well with Safe Sleep, with United Way.
Yeah.
We're a member, one of the founding members with many other folks in the Homeless Alliance. And we just added another 150 bed count to the community's inventory, and I guarantee you there will be more. So
we're getting there.
But people don't see it, and so you can't believe necessarily what you see on the street, because there are a lot of people coming in, getting help, getting the help that they need, and coming back to a new life. And so I'm sorry we just can't film that for everybody, but just
well, I wonder
know that
at
it's
times
happened.
If we'll ever get rid of that picture on the street. It's always been there, but it has gotten, certainly it's gotten more critical.
Sure.
One of the mottos is changing the face of homelessness one story at a time. And I want to kind of couple that motto with the really what I see is two programs you have, sort of the come on in, and then there's the sort of second story program of people really going through life changing.
Yeah, the new facility allows us on the third floor for men, 80 beds to go through an 18 to 20 month life change program recovery. It's Christian based. And again, even there, you have the choice of accepting or not. But guys who say, you know, I've been on the street, but I really do want life.
My life is out of control.
My life's out of control. and really, the relationships, again, are everything. They form tight bonds. Their first 6 weeks, they go through a class on shame where they just pretty much lie to each other until they're done lying. And they start to face what is what they got to get rid of, but what they got to take on, and friendships and the cohorts that develop over that 18 to 20 month program. Chuck, you couldn't pry it apart with a titanium blade.
When they finish that program, how many of them are able to stay sober for a year or two, or whatever your timelines are like?
Yeah, each of our graduating classes has a success rate. A year later, are they connected with their mentor? Are they working? Are they housed? Do they not only have a mentor, but do they have a support group? And are they going to church for those that accept that? And the bottom line is that when we last looked at it, it was about 82% for last year. And the national average is 60 to 65. Tight bonds with others make the difference.
One of the really, I think, big changes over at least my lifetime in terms of who's on the street. For the longest time, it was often economic, it was drug addicts, it was alcoholics. We've added, I think, tragically, the mentally ill.
Yeah.
How do you all deal with these? This is probably one of the most difficult problems I've seen, is that substantial change in that population.
We've been blessed to hire three mental health counselors that are rock stars, Chuck.
Right.
They're connected with Marion County and Polk County mental health counselors. Right next to where the men's mission is, Bridgeway Addictions Recovery, right next door. They're planning on building some detox capabilities in there as well. But as well, we're connected with all the mental health care providers. Northwest Human Services is a big supporter.
Yeah.
And we were blessed with this group that came into the old mission, a medical clinic called JD Health and Wellness. And they just said, hey, we just want to help. We want to help you with telehealth. We've got doctors and nurses.
Fantastic.
They do all of our COVID testing so that everybody who wants to come in can come in. And obviously, they have to go through the COVID test. And even if they're positive, they go to the wellness room, the sick bay, until they're ready to be able to participate in all of the activities in the shelter. So nobody gets turned away. But having that mental health component in not only those connections, but as well having our own mental health counselors, and we've got three of them full time, and we're going to be getting more.
Yeah.
We really are helping them stabilize, get the meds that they need in the time frame that they need them in.
Right.
You don't give somebody who's on the verge of crisis a 90-day supply of pills. It doesn't work that well.
No.
So we really help them work through a lot of issues.
That's great. And I know that we will have on the screen a way to contact UGM if people want to participate with you as a volunteer. Financially, just pray for the organization.
That's it.
Those three things I know are fundamental to the mission there. And thank you. This community, you mentioned the word blessed. This community is blessed to have UGM both in the community, growing, and incredibly vital. It's something we really appreciate very much.
Well, appreciate all your support. And
thanks.
We've got a lot of work to do, and we're encouraged every day to do even more. So
thank you very much,
you bet.
Dan.
Thank
really
you to all the donors.
You
as
bet.
Well. We need it.
Thank you.
You bet, Chuck.